Watch Dogs Legion. A warm welcome to all of our friends, fans, community members, squad mates and participants and viewers on various platforms. Thank you for joining us today. Thank you for being here for Watch Dogs Legion, part of our Dear Bermuda introducing series here on Twitch. Thank you to all who were here with us earlier as well for my podcast, which I just finished. And we are starting out with this adventure a bit later than usual, but still plenty of time for us to get through some of the activities here, part of their Watch Dogs Legion campaign in London. We are fighting those tyrants, the new organization that is trying to impose some really stringent rules. And so far so good, the experience of the game has been very positive. I did mention earlier that I felt maybe the activities were slightly disjointed from the actual story initially. It did begin with an activity that seemed to be completely well connected with the leaders and the HQ, but then as we carried on, it became a bit fuzzy. But maybe it's just, you know, maybe it's just me. Maybe it's just the way I'm playing the game at the moment, trying to explore the streets of London and the characters. And, you know, I was most excited about the capacity the game was offering for any NPC, any character met on the streets, to be selected as a faction member. And still didn't get my teeth into this too well, and managed to select one person for a faction yesterday. And we'll try to do exactly the same thing today. So, without further ado, we've heard all about the news and our community members and everyone earlier in the podcast, then we'll just crack on with some fierce activity here in Watch Dogs Legion. So let's just crack on. Well, we selected Catherine Jackson yesterday. She is the first big member of our squad, and we need to find out really what will happen next. So let's go to Connie's pub. Need to use our map quite a bit. So this pub is very far away. Reporting for duty in your mission. Where's the nearest underground station in there? Embankment. Well, we'll go to Embankment Walk from there, because at the moment we're in Camden. But this game's actually played the best as a proper big open world one, you know? You don't want to be doing lots of shortcuts. And generally, I could have grabbed a vehicle and then simply drive through the streets, but we're played by ear, really. I'm just aware of the fact that my timing will be determined by the free play, meaning on Sunday night, I'll lose access to the game. Therefore, I'll try to cram in as much of my own activities possible. Campaign missions in particular can really examine every one of the characters. So this character here is Sally Jackson. She's a janitor. Does remind me of the Division 1, because I remember when that game came out, so there was some concern that just around the streets a lot, there was hardly any activity, and I think this is going to be similar. This very moment may heat up, so a lot more action. A few times where the enemy spotted us and everyone in London will remember the old building that's been demolished. It doesn't exist anymore. True fact, same site. That was a bit careless for me. Yesterday I was examining very many of those citizens, but I think today we'll just look at the action or the story. To connect with whatever the game is asking us to do. So many times down here, so many times in who's this? Caleb Jackson, unemployed. Well, that's not really a very rosy picture of the unemployed. So. Out that.
Comply with all instructions while passing through the checkpoint. Suspected members of DedSec will be detained.
Got in. Right.
DedSec resurgence have prompted Parliament to approve the use of lethal force for Albion contractors. CEO Nigel had this to say.
DedSec terrorists will quickly find that Albion, unlike the force of this city, is battle-tested and proven in the field.
The Prime Minister's office has called this shoot-to-kill mandate a drastic but necessary...
Crazy out there, right? Here, your new optic.
So this is it, yeah? Goodbye to my normal life. Everyone, really. Once I'm in.
What's normal? The government's literally letting Albion shoot us in the streets.
I know. And I want to help. Really, I do. But walking away from everything isn't easy.
You're not leaving anything behind. You're helping to make the world a better and safer place.
You're right. Okay, I'm ready.
Welcome to the Resistance.
Welcome to Resistance.
Right. Welcome aboard, etc., etc. I'll give you the speech later. Right now, we need you and your big, strong drone friend to get on top of SIRS HQ and steal a server. Think you can handle that?
On my way.
So let's see, what do we got next? Extraordinary considering how many characters you need. Each one of them will have an ID.
No fuck about of that, you horses.
Not interesting.
Turn left. Mortician. That's not bad.
Fine.
Let's clear the first.
Well, what the bloody hell are you gonna do about it? This is a free country.
How about that now? Why don't you try and tell me more about your rights?
Think this is funny? This again? Can let you rot in jail, so don't act tough. Now get the fuck out of my face.
Uh-huh. Hello? Uh-huh.
outside.
I'm still working up to it, honest.
Do you have any idea of working against the house?
I'm here.
I'll highlight the server with the AR reconstruction software. It's out of reach, so you'll need to use a heavy cargo drone to steal it.
No.
Oh, yeah? What am I looking at here? Oh God, what is that?
Trickier than I said.
What is that drone doing?
Thank you.
I loaded the server into your vehicle. You're good to go. Drive safe. You have precious cargo now.
Don't worry. I passed my driving test with colors.
Drive the truck.
Pursuing the suspect.
You're too far. far. I'm served from your optic, so I need you to stay within range.
Control, we are unsighted of suspects. Over. Control, we are pursuing the suspects. Over. Target has cleared checkpoint on.
Sight of the target. Over.
Control, we are still on the suspect. Over.
Pursuing the suspect.
Suspect has cleared the checkpoint.
Force them to a stop.
Target's crashed their vehicle, over.
It's taking too much damage. A few more hits and it's toast.
Thank you.
went through a checkpoint. Over.
I'm in pursuit of the target.
To apprehend the suspect.
Preparing to ram suspect vehicle.
We're on their tail. Over.
Danger. Vehicle in critical condition. Please exit immediately.
Chance to get that data.
Thank you.
CTOS AR. Data reconstruction in progress.
This will do. Remain in the area until I've downloaded enough data to the server.
What on earth was I doing there driving to the tower?
Download complete. I need a wider sample of data, so I'm pushing you the coordinates to a new location. This is brilliant. Look at this. It's compiling data from the surveillance infrastructure. Nearby CTOS drones, civilian optics, CCTV, and then it assembles those scraps into what happened in this location 24 hours ago. Fantastic.
CTOS AR. Data reconstruction in progress.
All right. Scraping data from optics, CTOS cameras, microphones, laptops. Say, do you reckon SRS uses this to watch people shag? Fucking hell. Do they use it for anything but watching people shag?
Bagley, we have company.
Well, shit. Can you do anything to lose your new friends? Maybe invite them to a pottery night or overshare something personal. Whatever you do, just get to the last location in one piece.
Jesus. All right, fine.
Transfer complete. I'm missing one last data set. Pushing you the coordinates to the location now.
Target
not there. Searching.
Come back. Mark. Microsoft Store is up there. funny if I was walking on there, somebody drove the truck like that. So what do we go here? Oh no, we're turning right.
Suspect.
Help, Bags! They're still on me!
Don't let the drones destroy the server before I'm done. Get out of the lorry and take care of them. Shoot them. Throw rocks at them. Destroy them psychologically with cyberbullying. Just keep them busy until the transfer's complete.
Stupid git.
Alright, I've got it. Now, we can't lug around this server forever. We should probably wipe our prints off it anyway.
Go on.
I'll overload the CPUs to cause a power spike and destroy the battery unit. The electromagnetic pulse should destroy both the server and the drones. So, you know, run! Was fun, wasn't it? We pulled off a heist, made life a bit harder for the tyrants of the world, and most importantly, I got a new toy to play with. Now, run along back to the safe house. Sabine wants you and your new teammate briefing. It's a Piccadilly Circus for you, as you can see. There's also Tesco's down here. Sometimes I go to it on the corner if I'm going to Palace Square, Haymarket or Leicester Square again.
I guess. No, listen. Just breathe, all right?
fucking shacks. That's off English origin. Mission Impossible with Tom Cruise. Suddenly rain does not want to work. Rain's gone dead. Not got carriage service. Well, yeah, I remember that from the demonstration, the demo on the 10th of November. Trafalgar Square. That's beautiful.
ID check, come here, right now.
You joking? I didn't do a thing.
So one thing that doesn't really resemble London here, it's the absence of vehicles. There's hardly any vehicles here in the game. The streets, yeah, it's really busy. Has been completed, very good. Thank you. Let's have a look what's here waiting for us. It's a bit annoying because we are inside a base. We can't run.
Hello. This is crazy. Can't believe we're dead set now. No tutorial or anything?
It's too late for that. Better learn the ropes.
You know about imposter syndrome? It's that feeling you don't know what you're doing, even when you do. I actually don't. What if I accidentally say something bad to the wrong person? I wouldn't even know what to do.
Yeah, same.
Well, fake it till you make it, I guess. Even if an entire city is counting on you.
Talk to our chum in there. Looks like a worktop.
How's it going? Honestly, all of this is kind of a lot. Like, do I even belong here? Am I doing enough? Is this a game?
I know what you mean. It's rough, but this is real.
Right, so go back to acting like I know what I'm doing. Good advice.
Good advice. Looks like the base has been rebuilt. So we can see some time-lapse of them working properly and having as necessary. So this is, let's talk to Selene. Electrophist we picked up, I remember that yesterday. Team recruited 3 people. So we have Megan Powell, photographer, Kelly Christensen, hacker, Catherine Jackson, construction worker. These other guys are potential suspects, but recruits, because I selected them from the streets, really. A bit more. I think the environment looks more advanced than the design of the characters. Would you not agree? They don't really look like next-gen characters to me. So hold on, where do I see the currency? Show on map, please. That's good. Let's see how much money I've got. Missions, tech, team, data. Thank you. tie. So my friend in here looks awesome. Take a screenshot. The difference there is those green sneakers that don't seem to blend in too well, but you know, we'll get rid of that in due course.
Well done, team. It's good to see the safe house filling up again. The only way we're going to keep London from falling into total oppression is by rebuilding the resistance. We need to recruit, train, build back our arsenal. The people are itching to rise up and take their city back. We just need to show them that DedSec are fighting along with them.
I'm in. I want to take on the profiteers exploiting London for their own gain. Albion's taken our home and turned it into a war zone, silencing anyone who dares up to them.
Don't forget Clan Kelly. Those vultures keep exploiting people who have nothing left to give.
Fair, but remember that this zero-day hacker group is still out there. They took out DedSec once, and it's a good bet they'll try again. I believe they were responsible for the bombings and framed DedSec. With your help, I plan to get to the bottom of this mystery.
I'd say that's a full docket. Enough talk. Let's unfuck London.
And she got some currency.
I found a lead that may help us unravel more about Zero Day and the bombings we ate shit for. I've picked up an encrypted signal from the Tone conference site that's been broadcasting on a loop since the night of the bombing. Go investigate. You might even get to try out that fancy new AR tech we stole. I mean, creatively shared.
Sounds good. Find the signal source at Tone attack site. It's funny, a bit perturbing, you know, like the interiors are so beautifully designed, there's meticulous attention given to detail, but I think the characters really could have done a bit more. But the game's atmospheric. It gives us a lot of flavour of what London's like, but I'm still, like I said yesterday, we're roaming the streets and there's no music which is associated with London. They could have put some Blur music or, you know, you know, any of those tunes which are associated with.
Turn it down two notches, yeah?
Fucking rubbish.
Calm down, man. You're making a scene.
This will not end
like you spent shows for everyone.
That's it, somebody step up.
Okay. Right.
Oh, you're being long right now, you know?
The intel in here, and exactly that it is her boyfriend, and I think Virginia Johnson I picked up. As a potential recruit.
Albion Mercs tried to strong arm us, but we were like one big beast, you know, ready for any.
Drone expert. We need them. I'd love to get my hands on their tech.
Picked up. Oh no, it's a new mission.
Building a resistance group requires operatives with specialized skills. Technical abilities, firearms handling, and physical training are all valuable. Bare-knuckled boxing rings are a good place to find people who are good at throwing punches, or taking them. By defeating each opponent in an arena, you'll have an opportunity to face its best fighter. Prove your physical superiority, and they may consider joining DedSec. I'm guessing that's some sort of primate society thing.
Then what we ended up with is a really commercial model where whether you're talking about an app on a smart device or whether you're talking about a broadcaster, the most important thing was to keep you in that environment for the longest amount of time possible. And because that meant money in their pocket. And in order to do that, a couple of things happened. One was the use of manipulative techniques around behavioral economics, things that would just keep you scrolling or keep you listening or keep you looking for more information. The second is that that kind of environment favors sensationalism. And so you got more sensational headlines and more sensational stories, and it didn't matter whether they were true or not. It just kept people in and it kept them in the loop. So we ended up in a situation where nobody trusted anything and nobody believed anything at all. And that is the perfect environment for an authoritarian voice to come in and say, no way, we are the truth. So the ground for this environment really got created when we had suddenly authoritarian politicians everywhere, and anything that threatened them or they disagreed with.
God, there's nothing left here.
Feels wrong standing in the place where so many people died.
So what's with the security? This building should be under construction, not under guard.
Good point. Bagley, what exactly am I looking for?
Any kind of device or component that could still be emitting the signal. It seems to be coming from within the rubble.
Spiderbot leg. The leg piece of a damaged spiderbot recover from the town site.
What the hell?
This is it. The signal is coming from this spiderbot fragment. No indication yet who it belongs to.
I'm impressed it's transmitting anything at all in this condition. Where's the rest of it?
Difficult to say. But with an AR reconstruction, we may be able to see what happened to it and if it relates to the attack. Access data relays in the vicinity, and I can compile enough data to build the AR reconstruction.
Surveillance data. That's probably just lying around somewhere.
Perfect. Two more data relays to go. More data relay and I'll have it. That should do it. Now, I'll just take the audio from this stream and the video from these 36 and... Got it. Go back to where you found that spider bot, and I'll show you the AR reconstruction from the night of the explosion.
I understand.
Think we'd go back for you.
Don't trust the Kelly dog.
Wait, Kelly? As in Clan Kelly? So gangsters are behind the bombings?
Looks like a delivery. The Kellys were probably just the supplier.
Interesting. I wonder who they were meeting. She didn't look like Clan Kelly. Does that mean she's part of Zero Day?
Well, don't just stand there. Keep looking.
Similar to what we've seen in Splinter Cell and The Division, two of these games together. Taking place in London, of course, different environment, but the basic premise is very similar. The only difference here is you can select all the characters to become members of the faction. We'll see how this will all work in due course.
Bagley, can you tell me who is controlling the Spider-Bot?
I've now fully decrypted the signal the Spider-Bot is broadcasting, and while I cannot identify a specific user, it is a call code used by the Metropolitan Police Service.
Hold on, the police watched this happen?
The reconstruction continues behind that rubble.
One to transport. We can do that, right? Or, I don't know, quantum tunnel the space-time continuum?
Quantum tunnel technology is at least 10 years away, but Spider-Box and drones are here today. You could try one of those if you don't feel like waiting.
Good plan.
Why don't you aim those human eyeballs of yours at the van's cargo?
I understand.
Conference boss David Levin took part in the technology of all nations conference speaking on current advances in the field of autonomous litigation. He argued that AI could pave the way for major reforms in the criminal justice system. Judges would first be assisted and eventually replaced by AI that could weigh evidence and interpret the law in a truly unbiased way. Okay, so what do we need to do now? Missions.
RDX Nitrogen, and the exact same detonator system like the bombs that were planted at Parliament.
0 days calling card.
There, hurry. Got order delivery.
So you were hired to supply all the targets? Shut it, we're all on need to know.
So 0 day coordinated multiple groups to commit the bombings.
That's certainly one way to pull off a massive coordinated attack while remaining anonymous. 0 day needed manpower and resources, but they needed them at an arm's length. And it doesn't take the world's greatest AI detective to see that both Clan Kelly and Albion benefited in the aftermath. Unfortunately, this is the most we can get out of the AR reconstruction. But if we could find the mystery officer who was spying through the Spider-Bot, maybe they could tell us more. Tracing the Spider-Bot's serial number, it was assigned to New Scotland Yard 3 years ago. Perhaps more information about its user or its assignment will be available at the station.
It's hard to believe the police may have known who the real bombers were all along and never said anything to the public.
The only way to know for sure is to investigate New Scotland Yard.
I'll go to New Scotland Yard. All right. Sites. senior Scotland Yard. We know where it is. Passed a couple of times.
Please, I'm not gonna fight you right now. Please.
I'd like to think anyone can change, even Albion guards. Think we could recruit one of them?
This shit is not right, bro.
Go limp, or I will make.
Fleeing from Mike on. Well, the time's coming to the hour where I need to be having my dinner, so just a bit more, and then we'll have a break, and once I come back, we'll carry on with another late night stream like yesterday. It's pretty usual for me to do that, but we are to do it because of time limit given to us. Characters, so it's kind of a mixture. It does give this impression, I have to say, the game at the moment isn't playing, it does feel like a work in progress. It doesn't feel like a fully fledged, fully finished game. And to be fair, it's maybe a good description, because for a game of this magnitude, this massive open world, just the work on DLCs and evolution of the story and everything else. Together it's been good so far, but I just think there's lots of empty runs when you're walking the streets, there's nothing going on because you're not being, like in Division, spotted and alerted by the Albion guards or the police or anyone else. And even when I was driving, I caused some car crashes and traffic, and there's nothing, there's no response. Geraldine Davis. But you know what's funny? After you play the game for a while, and after you've been checking out every single character, it becomes second nature. So when you start walking the streets in real life, you'll try to do the same. So it's really weird. Oh, that's fantastic. What a good sight. Good God. Oh, that's good. I love it. Oh, yeah, that's cool. So good. That's gonna be a good frame. That's the Scotland Yard.
problem. It looks like Albion overtook the station.
And the entire police service. But don't worry, if you're not pleased with your privatized goon squad, just take your business across the street.
Pretty sure that privatizing the police force defeats the purpose of having police.
Not to worry. The only difference now is the uniform, assault weapons, and the fact they're motivated by profit over public service. Now, any record or information on the Spider-Bot will be further in.
Search for evidence and New Scotland Yard's going to get in.
Moving to the alarm.
Send that alarm off. Let's take a look.
So this will not work. There we got that.
Stay alert! Boots alarm! We're all clear!
So we can't be getting in through,
oh, hell!
Alright, my friends, I think it's the best time for me to depart and get my dinner, and after that, when I return, we'll resume with our stream. Hope you enjoyed all you've seen so far. Certainly it's a very stealthy, very quiet, very slowly evolving game from what I've seen so far. I'm doing the campaign and story-based missions. We selected two faction members so far, and completed a number of quests. Did manage to pick up some audio tapes as well, which is similar to what we have in the Division, and we'll just carry on, and I'll see really how far we can progress until we come to the cut-off time on Sunday, and we'll do as much as possible, and enjoying it so far. I think it's a good game, and I guess for myself, maybe slightly deflated, because I feel that the story and the activities are not really kind of perfectly blending us yet. But as we carry on, we'll see. There may be some fantastic action sequences, or any other activities that really kind of grab me and bring me in. On the other night, I had a bit of a problem with soundtrack. I think it doesn't represent London at all, and so far we've not seen any of the tunes which are London specific and London based. You know, The Clash, London Calling, Beetlebug, Blur, Anarchy in UK, Sex Pistols. You know, the list just goes on and on. We find lots of other tracks, and Waterloo Bridge, Kinks, and it just, you know, feels good. Unfortunately, there's that but at the end, and we'll really carry on exploring to find out whether it will be completely dispelled, and you know, we'll have a properly fully fledged, very dynamic game ahead of us. I think so far it's been popular, but from what I gathered, also is a thought that perhaps it's not performing as well on the sales front as people expected it to be. I'll dig into this and have a look. But I did see that there were some words of caution launched at the publisher, as they felt there was a massive overflow, but there was a lack of content. But you know, we've heard this about Cyberpunk and a few other games. I think you need to allow the developers to build the content, and similar to what we've seen in Destiny, for instance. As we carried on, there was more and more to come, and therefore the game took shape and became what we know of it today. Alright, so I'm gone, and once I come back, we'll carry on. So, all of you have a really good dinner, and for the other members who perhaps are not going to be joining us later on, I wish you all a very, very good evening. Hope you're enjoying all the games offered to us on PS Now and Xbox Game Pass, and see you all later.